Hey guys, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So let's begin today's video, which can be of use for your upcoming SEBI examination. Along with SEBI, you can also use these questions for your RBI examination as well as other examinations at the level of banking PU. So let's begin. But before that, the important information for you all is that this PDF is downloadable and the link of the PDF is in description below. So you can download it from the Telegram channel of ours, and for that you need to have the Telegram application in your mobile phone. Okay, so now let's begin with our first question. I hope that I'm clear with the PDF downloading thing. So the first question is, which committee has recommended the creation of the Indian Environment Service in the Central Bureaucratic Structure? So we have five options: N.C. Saxena Committee, G. Srinivasan Committee, Praveen Kutumb Committee, Vinod Pol Committee, T.C.R. Subramanian Committee. So here the right answer is option E, T.C.R. Subramanian Committee, which recommended the creation of Indian Environment Service. Like we have the Indian Administrative Service, Indian Revenue Service, Indian Foreign Service, and many more services within the central bureaucratic structure. Okay, so why was this position created by the center, or basically why has the Supreme Court mandated the center to create such a position within the administrative structure? What is the need and what is the news surrounding it? That is something that we are going to discuss in this first question. Okay, so Supreme Court has mandated it as an answer to the petition which was filed by the senior advocate K. Sultan Singh. Guys, do remember his name. He has filed the petition on creating the Indian Environment Service. Now, you need to understand what is the need of creating the Indian Environment Service altogether as a separate position within the central bureaucratic structure. So the need is that this TSR Subramanian Committee also suggested this thing, that the policies of India related to environment are really good in nature, they are stringent, but their implementation is weak. Therefore, in order to strengthen the implementation of the environment laws in India, this new position has been created, and TSR Subramanian Committee had recommended creating such a post back in the year 2014. Okay, so the year 2014 is the same year in which the TSR Subramanian Committee was created to suggest the ways to strengthen the implementation of the environment laws. So I hope that I am clear till now, and in case you get any kind of query or there is something that you don't understand, feel free to ask me in the comment section below. Next is that this committee, the TSR Subramanian Committee, was created in 2014, and it was created by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change to review the environmental laws and how can we implement them better. So these are some of the recommendations given by the TSR Subramanian Committee back in the year 2014. Since this is in the news, therefore they can ask you any one of these statements in the examination or the recommendations given by the TSR Subramanian Committee, as well as the year in which it was formed, okay, or the task for which the TSR Subramanian Committee was created. Okay, so you need to prepare this committee from all these dimensions, from all these perspectives. So the committee was created in 2014 and it submitted its report in 2014 itself. Month is not at all important for you to memorize. Okay, so you can just skip the month in which the report was submitted or the committee was created. Okay, next point here is that this report mentioned that India has a strong legislative framework in relation to the environment, but a weak implementation structure. That's why the environmental laws are not being implemented in India at a scale that was envisaged in the law itself. Okay. Next is, to ensure implementation, this committee itself recommended to create this Indian Environment Service, and the qualification or the examination detail or the roles and responsibilities will be described later on. Since the order has been given, the mandate has been given by Supreme Court right now. Now it's the prerogative of the central government to create the entire structure of this Indian Environment Service, and we will get to know this thing. And it's a really positive point from the new PSC aspirants' point of view as well, because a new service is also being created. Obviously, you also need to know this thing, that since we are creating a new kind of service, and that two pertains to a specific sector, that is environment. Therefore, in my opinion, there would be a certain kind of extra qualification requirement from the students, from the aspirants in relation to environment. Okay, so let's see what is going to happen. But this is the entire news, and I have already cautioned you that you need to prepare the TSR committee itself. Okay, and the relevant points from where the question can be framed, I have already provided you all of them. Okay, so this is stating the status quo. Like, at present, the people who are selected by UPSC as the IAS officers, they go to the secretariat, and then in the Ministry of Environment, they finalize the laws and they take care of the implementation of the laws. But here, what is the need for creating a separate unit when already existing IAS officers are doing this work? The need is the specification, the specific knowledge that is required from the environment point of view. So in order to have individuals that are trained in the environment technique or environment domain, this new service has been created. Now let's move on to the next question. Where is the Reba Award winning Friendship Hospital located? Okay, so here the right answer is Bangladesh. Now let's see what is the entire news all about. So this Friendship Hospital, which is located in Satkira town in Bangladesh, has recently won the Royal Institute of British Architects Award. Okay, that is why this hospital is in the news. It is basically an 80-bed community hospital. And do remember this point regarding this hospital, that it is very sustainable in nature. It has been built in a sustainable manner, as well as it has many activities like water harvesting, etc., etc., that is done in a sustainable manner. So that is the information that you need to know regarding this Friendship Hospital. Although this cannot be asked in the examination from you, but it was just for your knowledge. Next point that is of importance is the architect. Okay, so Keshav Chaudhary is the architect who has designed this hospital. So do remember his name as well. Moving ahead, who has been appointed as the new chairman and managing director of Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited? So here the right answer is Pushp Kumar Joshi. Which of the following company has become the fourth Decacorn of India? Okay, Swiggy, Razorpay, Upgrad, BharatPay, Meesho. The right answer here is option A, Swiggy. So far, we have heard unicorns, right? But what is Decacorn? Unicorns are the companies or the startups that have a valuation of over $1 billion, right? US dollar $1 billion. Decacorns are the startups or the private companies that have a valuation of over $10 billion. Okay, wait here, the list does not end. We have Unicorn, we have Decacorn, and we have Hectocorn as well. So Hectocorns are the companies, private companies or startups who have a valuation of over $100 billion. So this is the list. Maybe more new terms would be added in the future as the companies would grow in nature and size. But as far as the list at present is concerned, this much is the list that you need to know. Okay, so Swiggy has become the fourth Decacorn of India with a valuation of US dollar 10.7 billion. Okay, apart from Swiggy, we have three more Decacorns, which are the Paytm, Oyo, and Bytunes. Okay, so these three are the Decacorns. I have already explained the definition of Decacorn and Hectocorns, okay? The companies which have a valuation of over $100 billion. Next point that you need to know is that in the world stage, in the international market, Facebook was the first company to become a Decacorn back in the year 2007, okay? So I hope that you can remember this much as well from the exam point of view. And that's all regarding this news. Now let's move on to the next question. Which state has established the Gram One centers to provide the government services in rural areas from one center? Okay, so it is just like the Commerce Service Center that the center has established. Now a state has also endeavored to establish the Gram 1 center. So which state is it? It's Karnataka. Okay, basically the idea is very similar. Like we have the Common Service Centers, similar is the idea of the Gram 1 centers, but do not think that it is just the remodeled version of the Common Service Center within the state of Karnataka. No, these two initiatives are completely different. I just draw a line of similarity between these two things so that you can understand the purpose of this Gram 1 center. Okay, so what would be the functioning of this Gram 1 center? It will basically provide all kinds of government services to the rural people under one roof. Okay, it is basically to make it easier for the rural people to access the government services. Next is, which state has launched the first of its kind brain health initiative? Again, Karnataka is the right answer. Now guys, this initiative, first of all, let me tell you that it has been launched in collaboration with NIMHANS and Niti Aayog. Okay, so do remember the organizations. NIMHANS is based in Bangalore itself, and Niti Aayog is the central think tank, the think tank of the government. NIMHANS stands for the National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences. Do remember this full form of NIMHANS. Now, what is the purpose of this brain health initiative? Under this initiative or this program, basically training will be provided to the doctors so that they can further provide consultation to the mental health patients in order to treat them, okay, and also to screen them, basically in order to match the qualitative standards in terms of mental health treatment. This initiative has been launched by the state of Karnataka. Okay, to train the doctors, to train the medical practitioners who are specifically working in the field of mental health in terms of quality standards and what kind of consultation should they give and what kind of the prescription should they prescribe. All these things come under the training that will be provided under this brain health initiative of the state of Karnataka. Okay, I hope that this news is clear. There is nothing much that you need to cram your mind with. So it's just a basic program that has been launched in order to train the medical practitioners, particularly those who are working in the field of mental health. Next point is that it has been launched in 3 districts right now on a pilot basis, not the complete state of Karnataka. Okay, so these 3 districts are Bangalore, basically Kolar and Chikkaballapur districts. Okay, no need to memorize the names of the districts because they are not going to be asked from you. Remember, it's SEBI examination, it's the RBI for which you are preparing, not the Karnataka PCS. Okay, so guys, here this video ends. I hope that you have liked the content provided by us, and if you really like it, then do not forget to subscribe the channel, hit the bell notification. You can also share this video among your friends and enlighten them as well. Like this video if you really liked it. Thank you so much for watching the video. Keep learning.